Once, up on a time, there was a very brave turtle who wanted to climb a mountain. The mountain he wanted to climb was in front of Turtle Land. It was a mountain so high that no turtle could see the top. "Why do you want to climb that mountain?" the other turtles would ask. "To see what is beyond it," the very brave turtle would answer. "But no one knows if it has a top, and even if it does, how could you, a turtle, climb to it?" "Everything I know that has a bottom has a top. And I know the mountain has a bottom, so it must also have a top. As for climbing to it, if I stayed in Turtle Land all my life, I would walk many steps, and at the end, I would be in the same place where I began. Instead, I will use my steps to climb the mountain. Then I can be sure, at least, of ending my life higher than I began it." "What about the road that lies between Turtle Land and the mountain?" asked a turtle who had been to that road. "There are creatures on it so large they shake the earth when they move. They could crush a turtle in an instant. It is too dangerous." "If there were no danger, I would not have to be so very brave," said the very brave turtle. "There is nothing I can imagine that would be worth such a climb," said one of the other turtles. "The view is worth the climb," said the very brave turtle. "From the top of the mountain I shall see where I am, where I have been, and where I could go. Then I can choose to return to Turtle Land, stay upon the top of the mountain, or continue moving forward. If I return to Turtle Land, it would be with knowledge beyond the vision of any turtle who ever lived. If I stayed upon the top of the mountain, I would be the highest turtle in the world. And if I moved forward, I would be moving towards something greater than that knowledge and higher than that height." With that reason, the very brave turtle left Turtle Land, headed in the direction of the mountain. The bottom of the mountain was not very far, but even not very far takes a turtle a long time. The earth was rough, and moving forward was difficult. But he had made up his mind to climb the mountain, and he was getting closer. Suddenly, the ground beneath his feet became hard. "This must be the road," said the very brave turtle to himself. "I must try to not be afraid. I will think only of being on the other side." And so, with thoughts of his being on the other side in his head, the very brave turtle started to cross the road. He had gotten almost across when he felt the earth shaking and heard a terrible noise. Quickly, he pulled his hands, feet, and head inside his shell. Though he knew his shell would not hold up to something so heavy, it shook the earth. He tried very hard to think about the mountaintop, for he felt that those thoughts were the only part of him that could not be crushed. He raised his thoughts to the mountaintop, and the noise stopped, and the earth became calm. For a moment, everything was still. The very brave turtle opened his eyes and was about to put his head out of his shell when he felt he was being lifted, gently carried through the air. He put his head out and looked. He was moving through the air toward the top of the mountain. I am flying, said the very brave turtle, half to himself and half to the earth moving below him. The top of the mountain came closer and closer until it stopped very softly under his feet. The very brave turtle felt a gentle hand upon his back. He put his head out as far as it would go and looked up to see. "A giant who is strong enough to carry me up a mountain, yet so gentle his touch feels like a breeze upon my back," But the light above the mountaintop was so bright that he had to close his eyes for a moment. Turtleland was very dark, thought the very brave turtle. My eyes are not used to this light. You shall have to look very carefully, said the gentle giant. So he opened his eyes and looked very carefully. Everything was clear. It was more beautiful than he had ever imagined. The top of the mountain was covered with soft, golden grass, which felt warm under his feet. All around him was a golden world of meadows. The grass, the brooks, the trees, everything is golden, said the very brave turtle. Yes, everything is golden, said the gentle giant, as he watched a golden butterfly come to rest upon a golden flower in the golden grass just in front of the very brave golden turtle.